Logan Paul claims Floyd Mayweather stole from him as he is yet to be paid his exhibition fee. It's been 6 months. So let's get right into the story. So Logan Paul claimed Sunday that Floyd Mayweather stole from him as he is yet to pay the exhibition fee from their unofficial boxing match in June 2021 at the Hard Rock Stadium in Miami Gardens, Florida. The content creator pulled off the improbable last year when he survived 8 rounds with Mayweather, a former 5-weight world champion fighter, one of the best boxers of all time. So Paul outweighed Mayweather by a considerable margin, but the YouTuber claimed a symbolic victory of sorts because the boxer failed to knock him out. Now there's like a little bit of controversy whether or not he was knocked out because of that weird like shoulder thing, but it could have just been Logan Paul putting his weight on Floyd Mayweather. The only two people that really know what happened in that ring are them two. So his brother Jake Paul falsely claimed on Twitter that Logan had won the exhibition. So after the match, Logan told reporters that Mayweather was slower than he expected and that he wanted to jump in the nearby water and get drunk. 6 months later, Logan revisited the exhibition in a social media post in which he accused Mayweather of failing to pay his fee for the bouts. "The dirty little rat hasn't paid me yet," Paul wrote. "It's been 6 months." In the same post, he said Mayweather stole from him. In the same post, he said Mayweather stole from him, but would make back the money when his trilogy bout with the YouTube rival KSI is set to be announced on January 4th. Now, here's the thing. I don't believe that it was actually announced that they're actually going to be fighting, but they might be just working together on something, maybe like NFTs, more of like the cryptocurrency space, because apparently Logan Paul has been working on something for quite a while. And if I'm not mistaken, it actually has to do with basically a knockoff of Pokemon called Zoo something, I believe. And it's basically like you're creating like a mixed match of like different animals all together. Like, that's like the rumors as to what they're actually working on. Could be that, could be not. Either way, they're probably going to make a lot of money. Because you got to think about it too, right? Both KSI and Logan Paul have made millions of dollars in the cryptocurrency space, right? Now, I think KSI is a little bit more legitimate in terms of being involved into the crypto space than Logan Paul, but Logan Paul is definitely smart enough to figure out a way to milk the crypto space for a lot of money. Like, he's a very smart individual. Like, it's very, very rare for someone at his age to be good enough or skilled enough in different aspects of life and just basically in anything to where he could find success there, right? So for example, he found success in boxing. How many people can say that they boxed Mayweather? No matter how you look at it, that's a very successful thing. YouTube. He is one of the largest YouTube creators in the world and still has been, even though he rarely posts anything. He is, I think, in the top 100 podcasts in the world as well. Like, he owns that. He's able to basically create brands out of nothing. For example, his co-host, Mike, the guy who wrote the book. So, like, he's able to get into different industries and be in the top of that industry. Now, he may not be the number one spot, but he ends up becoming successful in pretty much every industry, especially if it deals with social media in some form. So it's just very interesting to see what would end up happening and how much money he could probably actually be making from the crypto space with his new project, right? Because again, I don't think him and KSI are going to be probably fighting ever again. I think that they're going to go super heavy in the crypto space and probably end up becoming one of the first billionaires in terms of like influencers from the crypto space. I could easily see that happening just because of their social media following, just because of how good they are at marketing, right? So for example, right? Like Logan Paul is like basically his own brand. Like he's very good at marketing himself, right? KSI is very different in that KSI has been able to create a massive empire that doesn't just rely on him. So what I mean by that, KSI has the whole sidemen aspect, right? Which means that he could utilize the sidemen to push pretty much anything, right? Especially if that's going to make them a lot of money as well, everyone in that group. So the marketing power of these two individuals will easily destroy any marketing that Mayweather could ever do, right? And this is the reason why, someone like Logan Paul or like even Jake Paul can make millions of dollars when they fight is because of the marketing aspect that they have, like the marketing strength that these two individuals have. And here's the thing, who knows? It could end up being something where Logan Paul teams up with KSI and they bring everyone that they're super close with, so like Jake Paul, the Sidemen, basically everyone that has like massive followings and massive social pull, and they end up basically promoting a project that could probably take over the crypto space. Now, it won't take over Bitcoin, it won't take over Ethereum or Cardano probably, but in terms of like maybe like the NFT space, they could probably pull something off where they take it over. Just because of how big their pool is. Not to mention, if they end up bringing someone, let's say, for example, like Mr. Beast, Jimmy Donaldson, what they could do, leveraging Mr. Beast as well, would be insane, right? Because we're talking about someone who, because of social media, was able to launch restaurant chains to multiple different countries out of thin air, right? Now, obviously, that took a lot of planning, that took a lot of setup, still taking a lot of probably headaches that he has to deal with, but it kind of goes to show you the strength that these super influential people actually have, right? Because if you could garner, I don't know, maybe a billion plus impressions or a billion plus views altogether of all the people, it's going to be insane, right? Because they only need a small percentage of the people that end up watching all their stuff that might be promoting this stuff, which, by the way, none of them are probably going to ever have to spend money on it to promote it just because of how big of a followings they all have and how good they are at marketing, that it would not be surprising that if they get enough of these top tier influencers, that they could promote an NFT project or a crypto project that will like generate disgusting amounts of revenue, right? And like for example, right, there has been a lot of discussions about these like crypto casinos. Well, a lot of these crypto casinos have been like basically paying somewhat big influencers a decent amount to promote, their online unregulated casino, right? And these casinos that are unregulated in the crypto space that are paying these somewhat decent sized influencers, nothing to the likes of like the size of Logan Paul, Jake Paul, or Mr. Beast, but like the 1 million follower range, 1 to 3 million follower range, these casinos are generating hundreds of millions of dollars every single year in terms of just like profit in the crypto space. So you could see how something like an unregulated NFT company or project could generate potentially even billions of dollars because of their social media following. Now, is that actually going to happen? Who knows? It could be one big total flop. The main thing is, a lot of these big social media influencers are probably going to push super hard into the NFT space. And so, what that means is that perhaps if you were to get into the NFT space, at least for like a side thing, you might be able to make some money or decent sized returns in that. But only get involved in that type of space, into the crypto space or NFT space, once you're out of debt. So if you want to learn how to get out of debt, go to 40andBucks.com.